That's what we're calling.
Listen, I'm nervous.
I told you, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to have some off-the-shelf guests.
Elise Blatt.
And look, donuts. She left the couch for the bench. Georgia Whitkins.
Roy Furman.
Renee Steinberg.
His name is Jeffrey Bragman.
Richie Barry.
Liz Marigold.
Sky Chief.
Sky Chief. We have Tony Duke right here.
All right, I'm going to call it the auto show.
Keep your legs crossed. I have a very nice deal going.
I stopped 27 years ago.
Io sono Roberto Strada.
I'm on the eternal search for the perfect man.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, here we are, our first show on the bench in front of Dresden's Market in East Hampton. I'm Charlie Glassman. Here's my partner, Jeffrey Dell.
Right, let's talk about our show starting. Okay, Charlie and I sat here, and just the two of us, and we counted people we knew walking by in East Hampton. And the first day, I won 2-1. The second day, we won 5-3.
We're looking to interview some beautiful women today.
And the last time we did it, we were up to 75-68. But now we decided, because of that, we knew all these people, and all we were doing waving at them, we decided to interview them.
I did it once, but I'll never do it again.
On the bench.
On the bench, Jeff Dell, Charlie Glassman.
And our cameraman,
Paul Cohn,
is a dentist.
What's his motto?
No hole too big to fill.
Why are you here, and what are we doing?
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a real East Hampton icon.
Jerry Prize Realty at 52 Main Street, 324-8080, and we've got the best in real estate, be it rentals, lands, homes. I'll sell you anything, including a used car.
Dresden's Market was founded in 1920 by Mr. Dresden.
When did you get the idea for the donuts?
1950. Prior to 1950, there was a donut machine at the Five and Dime on Main Street, and he took it out around 1950. And we put in this automated machine.
And when did you become really famous and well-known for those donuts?
When we established our own recipe.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And it is a secret recipe, right?
For your information, they sell about 2,000 donuts an hour.
Sell a lot of donuts.
We've been told that we know cars are only allowed to park out here for an hour, in the parking lot for 2 hours. Marcus Shoe, only allowed to sit here for 20 minutes, we've been told. Parked in the long-term parking lot today. I got on the air-conditioned bus. I was in town in 30 seconds, and you can leave your car there all day long. You don't have to worry about this two-hour deal. And the bus, they have music, donuts, water, bottled water.
You get bottled
water? Bottled water, Dresden's donuts, air conditioning.
I have to keep my weight up.
My name is Olivia Fierro. I've lived in East Hampton for 8 years, and I like it a lot.
And are you working there this summer?
I help my dad sometimes.
And who do we have here?
Rose Tukulski.
Are you married?
Widowed.
Are you looking for a single man?
No.
So you're sure you're not looking? Because we do have some single men available.
No, I'm not interested.
Not interested. Rose, we want to thank you for coming and sitting on the bench with us.
When will I see this?
Oh, it's going to be around. Now you can watch the rest of the show if you don't mind. If you don't mind sitting right over there. Ladies and gentlemen, we have
Elliot Horowitz, an ex-chicken farmer from Tromser in New Jersey.
And what do you have in your pocket? A tooth? No, a pen.
Looks like a harmonica.
Little Country Road from you know who, John Denver.
Okay. Let me ask you a question. Are you married?
I was. I'm single.
Rose!
We've had a lot of single women on the show. Too bad you weren't here earlier when we had all our single women.
I'll take her sight unseen.
You'll take. Yeah, here's the date. How would you like to get married, Rose? And here we have Faith Popcorn, trendsetter.
We have Faith Popcorn and Gigi.
Sing a song, G.
Can you sing?
Hi, Gigi.
Hi, Gigi.
How do you get to have a job like that? Become famous and wealthy and well-known by predicting what's going to happen?
Well, I think it's called intelligence. Well, here they are together. We just fixed them up. He just put his arm around her. First couple to meet on a bench.
Rose is kind of bashful. My Rose of old San Antone.
Here they go. Is that Merv Matheson? The Mercedes honcho. Merv and his wife are in the newspapers a lot. They're at some of these big parties. I'm not going to name any names. Merv just moved into a new house. How's the house?
House is great.
Yeah, loves it. Yeah. East Hampton, of course.
Well, his wife, June Haynes, is the manager of Dolce & Gabbana, one of the hottest stores in Manhattan worldwide, right? I want to ask Merv this question. I always see Merv eating a lot of food. stand up. Just stand up for one more second. Come on. Stand up.
You're killing me.
I always see Merv eating a lot of food. But, and look at this body.
Lady. And me too. I eat a lot. Look at that.
We have June Haynes. Come on in here. She's a little camera shy. I know you can't believe it that this beautiful young woman is actually camera shy. Where'd you go after Nick and Tony's left?
Puffy had a party.
Puff Daddy! Puffy, come on in here!
Well, actually, it wasn't at his house. It was at the, I guess, the Synergy house.
Tell us a little about what you do.
I run Dolce & Gabbana and also do retail PR for the company.
One of the nicest things about this show is that we help put together some couples. Rose was here about 20 minutes ago, followed by Elliot. They didn't know each other. Now they're off someplace and having coffee.
Dr. Georgia Witkin, host of Beyond the News on Fox News Channel, and professor of psychiatry at Mount Sinai School of Medicine. But I'm here with Judge Milton Mollin. Give us a quote from the report.
One does not have to suffer from paranoia to see wrongdoing in the circumstances here.
How do you like Della Famina?
I love that they have an A-list.
I could feel better tomorrow night. We're going to Nick and Tony.
Yes, my gynecologist.
I've cured you for years.
Yeah, treated me for years. And here's what I turned out like. I lost everything, you know.
That's right. You look a lot different when we started.
Oh, thank you.
All right, we're waiting for Steven Spielberg. He'll be here in a couple of minutes. Puff Daddy, come on in here. How old?
I'm 12.
5. Grown up. We were talking about this yesterday. This really should be Main Street and not Newtown Lane. A main street of a town is where you get your coffee, where you have a donut, where you have a bagel. This is the heart of East Hampton right here.
We have John Steinberg, son of Richard and Renee Steinberg. A very up-and-coming, promising young man.
What are you doing with the show? It's going to hopefully be at the East Hampton Film Festival. Matter of fact, we're waiting for his father. His father promised to come back today. He had to go home and fix his hair, but he'll be back.
Okay, well, I wish I'd fixed my hair. If I knew this was going to be the film festival, I definitely would have wanted to.
Brittany, 5 minutes. We got to finish this interview. Here's Richard Steinberg. What a shirt. This is a real Hampton shirt.
All right, Richard, tell us a little about what you do.
So real estate.
Do you do anything interesting?
Get interviewed by On the Bench. That's pretty interesting, don't you think?
You're the wife of?
Richard Steinberg, mother of Jonathan Steinberg and Sarah. I didn't realize you have t-shirts made for this. On the Bench.
Jeffrey made them.
Oh, and
they're
you
soon
do too.
To be available all over the Hampton.
Very nice.
Newest thing in East Hampton, the buzz cut, ladies and gentlemen. Robert, what do you do out here in East Hampton?
Not a lot, Charlie. I'm really enjoying myself. Yesterday, Andy and I were flying a kite.
So not much. What do you think about Joe Lieberman for the vice president?
I think it's great.
That's all my answer. No wonder I look as bad as I do.
There are rumors going around that he eats bacon.
If I had ham today, he could eat bacon.
And you could see Barbara almost every single day walking in town with her friend. Here he is.
Come on, Harry.
Harry, very
good. Are you hungry, Harry? You are?
All right, Harry! Did they give you too much homework?
Yeah.
I'm running for mayor, and if you elect me mayor, I'm going to do away with all homework.
That's cool.
Let me tell you, this is a poem that that an elderly gentleman told one of my students when we went for a visit at a senior place. And this is the poem. God made man. He made him out of string. He had a little extra, so he made a little thing. God made woman, he made her out of lace, he ran a little short, so he left a little space.
And here we have the wonderful Kathleen Kirkwood. Come on in, Kathleen Kirkwood. Kathleen's an old friend. She came to the bench. Charlie, meet Kathleen.
Kathleen, nice to see you.
She's on QVC. She does all these kinds of shows.
Well, we're working on this exercise video. All right, the first thing you do is a dive all the way down.
And when do you start your yoga aerobics?
We're hoping January, right after New Year's Eve, where everyone wants to lose weight, get in shape. In, two pulses, and up.
That's why they call it yoga aerobics.
Don't
be nervous.
The donut is, it's kosher. Anybody have a joke back there?
Rose, do you know any jokes?
No.
Cheryl, do you know any jokes?
No, I'm very bad with jokes.
Can you tell us a joke?
No.
Anybody tell us a joke?
Man walks into a psychiatrist and said, Doc, I got this feeling nobody wants to talk to me. Psychiatrist said, next.
Called the plumber, I told him I got a leak in the sink. He said, go ahead.
So the man decides to take Viagra. He takes it, gets stuck in his throat. What happens to him? Gets a stiff neck.
A horse walks into a bar. Bartender says, why the long face? And another thing.
Bunny Dell, will you tell us a joke?
Okay, where did George Washington keep his armies?
Where did George Washington keep his armies?
In his sleeveys.
Here you go.
What's this for?
My new jokes.
First question is, how's business?
It's excellent. Are we rolling?
Denise is looking for a
she
single
man. Need any business.
Okay.
Just Spielberg. Let's get him over.
Steven, come on over here.
Mercedes
Hacho, Merv Matheson. Hi, Merv.
My name is Roberta.
Roberta Wolf.
Recently, I just completed a book with Trudy Schlachter, and what it is, it's all about the fashion designers. When it goes from the craziest to fabulous, like Stephen Sprouse said, soon we'll be wearing clothes that will change color according to our moods.
So you can afford to live in East Hampton?
I don't really afford to live here. I stay in other people's homes.
Larry, come on over.
What social work? What seems to be the biggest problem boys have today?
Girls, dummy. Spielberg, let's get him
over. Steven, come on over here.
Lori Schifino. I went to the puppy party too, and it was fun.
Yeah?
Why
are you here today?
Well, I'm here because you guys made me come.
Uh-oh. Puff Daddy, come on in here, Puff Daddy.
Look at that. Oh, my Lord.
Michael Braverman right here, ladies and gentlemen. Very famous real estate mogul.
Well, I'm no longer a real estate mogul. I'm a journalist, and I write about polo.
Is there a lot of interest in polo out here?
It's another party for the club kids. This year we've been doing a lot of benefits. Opening day was a benefit for the Princess Grace Foundation, and Prince Albert of Monaco was there. I asked him to come to your bench, but he didn't have time.
We do a lot of benefits. Here's one of our biggest benefits of East Hampton, Stuart Suna, owner of Long Island City.
We got to cut because he's on a haircutting break. Marcello is the hair cutter of the stars. He's got a salon out here in Echo.
Thank you very much. This is Marcello from Echo Salon, and this is my
hello.
Anyway, we're going to have to make this short because we got to get back to work. And the reason
not
I did
too
this
short, I like
is
a full
to
try. I had fun in the Hamptons. I'm a clinical psychologist. I work with adults who have affective disorders, depression and anxiety. And I, absolutely, you guys epitomize it, you know, in the book under depression and anxiety.
I talked to me, one of the most famous architects in East Hampton. And not only is he a famous architect, but look at, he's in incredibly physical shape, good condition. Girls, come on over, turn around, right over here on the bench with Jeff and Charles.
Those of you who have been watching and who are still with us, we'd like to thank you from all of our staff and our distinguished hosts, our cameramen, for all their support throughout today's show.
What are you two guys doing on this bench? This is like ridiculous, isn't it?
Question of the day is, who wants to be a millionaire? Well, you're watching the wrong show. Sorry.
You've got people in the street talking into a camera for no purpose at all.